Okay, let's talk about factoring what are called perfect square trinomials and the difference of two squares. Okay, so we're first going to start off with perfect square trinomials, and we're going to play a little game. The game is called Create Your Own Perfect Square Trinomial. And I've given you two out of the three terms of the trinomial, and you have to create your own perfect square. And here's how you do it. So the first thing you do is you can only play this game if you have perfect squares on the ends. And so you have to say to yourself, okay, what do you square to get that first term? That would be 2x. So I'm recognizing that 4x squared is 2x squared. Okay, and then plus blank, plus, and then what squared gives 9? That would be, of course, 3. Okay, so once you identify what it is that you square, here's what you do. In the middle, you put in the following. The number 2, and it's always the number 2 for perfect square trinomials, times, in this case, the 2x times the 3. Okay? And that's how it always is. It's always 2 multiplied by whatever you get after you identify what's being squared. And what's that equal to? Well, 2 times 2x is 4x times 3 is 12x. Okay? So you put a 12x in the middle there. And that's the end of the game. We just created our own perfect square trinomial. Okay? So our answer is that. That's what we call a perfect square trinomial. Let's try another one like that. Let's take something like, how about 25x squared minus blank plus 49. Okay, so the same game, right? You identify what it is that you're squaring. On the ends, right, it's going to be, let's see, 5x quantity squared minus blank plus, and then what do I square to get 49? Well, that's going to be 7. All right, and now what you do, what goes in the middle is going to be always 2 multiplied by, in this case, the 5x, and then multiplied by the 7. And when I multiply all these together, I get 10x times 7, which is 70x. So I put the 70x right there in the middle, and I have created my own, very own perfect square trinomial. So these are both what we call perfect square trinomials. Okay, so the reason we played this little game was it's crucial that you identify when you have a perfect square trinomial, okay? So recall that you have to have perfect squares on the ends. In the middle always has to be twice whatever it was that you were squaring multiplied together. So the middle was twice 2x times 3, and the middle down here was twice 5x times 7. Okay, let's take advantage of that now to factor a perfect square trinomial. Okay, so we're asked, first of all, are the following perfect square trinomials, and if so, factor. Well, I recognize that there's hope here because I have a perfect square on the end here and a perfect square over there. So first of all, what squared gives 36x squared? That's going to be 6x, right? Squared. And then what squared gives 25? Well, that's going to be 5. And I know from what we discussed a moment ago that the middle, right? Whatever goes in the middle right there, that should be 2 times 6x times 5. And what's that equal to? Well, 2 times 5 is 10, times 6 is 60x. So what I notice is that indeed I have 60x. So the answer to my question is, first of all, yes, it is a perfect square trinomial. Okay, so I do have the plus 60x here, so we're in good shape. Now, the way you factor these, once you've recognized that, is as follows. This is simply equal to 6x, that is the first thing you're squaring, and then either plus or minus the last thing you're squaring. In this case, it's plus the last thing you're squaring because the 60x in the middle was positive. So it's going to be 6x plus 5 whole thing squared. And that would be my answer. In fact, this is why we call this trinomial a perfect square trinomial, because it's the square of a binomial. Does that really make sense? Let me check it. What is 6x plus 5 squared? Now, you have to be really careful. this is not equal to 6x squared plus 5 squared. This is really 6x plus 5 times 6x plus 5. Let me rewrite that there. Okay, so we're multiplying these two together, and what do we get? Well, 6x times 6x is 36x squared. Now, notice what happens when you multiply 6x times 5. Well, you get 30x, right? But you get another 30x in here, and that's why you get plus 60x in the middle, and then plus 25. Notice that I got 30x twice, which is actually the logic here, right? That's why it's twice 30x in the middle there. Okay, so when you multiply these out, you do indeed get your perfect square trinomial. Okay, so now that we know how to do it, let's try another one here. Well, the key is, of course, recognizing that you have perfect squares on the ends. And 6x squared is, let's see, 3x whole thing squared. And then, well, we're hoping the middle is negative 24x. But I recognize the end, this other end as plus 4 squared. And I know that that middle has got to be 2 times 3x times 4. And what do I get? Well, 2 times 3x is 6x times 4 is 24x. And indeed, I have a 24x. Now, you may notice that there's a minus 24x, right? That there's a subtraction sign here. All that does is when you factor it, it's still very similar, but it looks like this. You still have 3x. But it's not plus 4 right here, it's minus 4. So you get 3x minus 4 squared. And that would be the factorization of this perfect square trinomial. Now you can check that this is right by multiplying it out like I did the previous one. And you're going to find that in the middle you get negative 24x. But when the time comes to multiply the negative 4 by the negative 4, that's going to bring you to a positive 16. So when you have a perfect square trinomial, the middle can be negative, but the end has always got to be positive. Okay, so that's how you do it. You first recognize when you have a perfect square trinomial, and then you simply get the first plus the last, or the first minus the last whole thing squared. Okay, now that we've talked about perfect square trinomials, let's go ahead and talk about the difference of squares. Okay, so the difference of squares is handled very similarly. What you want to do is you want to identify that what's being squared. So in this case, I can see 4x squared is really, well, 2x squared, and then take away, and 9 is 3 squared. Okay, so first of all, you have to classify, right? It's the difference, because it's subtraction, of two squares. And when you have that, here's what the factorization is. It's simply 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. Okay, and notice what happens when you multiply these out. You get 2x times 2x, which is how you get the 4x squared, right? So this will be our check. You get 4x squared, and then 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x, but positive 3 times 2x is plus 6x. And then positive 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. And what happens in the middle? Well, the negative 6x and the positive 6x cancel, and you get 4x squared minus 9. Notice that these cancel, and that's because a positive here and a negative there means that those signs will be different. So in the previous, you know, when you're factoring a perfect square trinomial, it was like 2x plus 3 times 2x plus 3. And that doubled the middle. They didn't cancel, right? You got plus 6x and plus 6x to get a positive 12x in the middle. It could have also been with perfect square trinomials a negative and a negative, in which case the middle wouldn't cancel. But when the signs are different in the middle, or when the signs are different here, you don't get a middle term. There's nothing with x there. Okay, so let's try this next one. Again, I look at this and I see that I have an x squared and a y squared. Now remember, when you're factoring, the first technique we have is factoring the greatest common factor. In this case, I see a 50 and an 18. They have a 2 in common, right? So it's going to be 2 multiplied by, well, 25x squared minus 9y squared. And now looking at this, I say, oh, I have a difference of two squares, right? And the reason is because 25x squared, that's equal to 5x whole thing squared. And 9y squared, that's 3y whole thing squared. So I have, again, the difference, right? That means subtraction of two perfect squares. And so what you get is, well, a 2 comes along for the ride, but you get 5x plus 3y multiplied by 5x minus 3y. And the fact that these signs are different means that there won't be a term in the middle. Okay? So that's how you factor a difference of squares. So now we know how to factor perfect square trinomials and the difference of two squares. Until next time.